الله الرحمن الرحيم. One of the brothers asked a question. He said that what I've heard is Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala in the Khilafat of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the son-in-law of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he practiced taqiyya. As in, he didn't really believe Abu Bakr to be the Khalifa, but he just pretended basically holy hypocrisy, religious hypocrisy, taqiyya. So is this true? Is it true that he didn't believe Abu Bakr to be the Khalifa and he rather believed himself to be the Khalifa? Is this true? A very simple answer. If this is true, then this would mean that the son of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and a great Imam of the Shias, Muhammad ibn Hanafiya rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu, was born from an illegitimate relationship. This is what it would mean. And not only would it mean that he was born from an illegitimate relationship, it would mean, na'udhu billahi min zalik, that the son-in-law of Rasulullah, the husband of Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, he has been indulging in wrongful relationships. He has been copulating with women who he is not in wedlock with. This is what it would necessitate. The reason for this is, why I say this, is because if we look in the Khilafat of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, there was a jihad in which Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu also participated. He fought this jihad under the instructions of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And in this jihad, Ali radiallahu anhu captured a woman from the tribe of Hanafiya, which he took her as a concubine, and he engaged in coitus with this woman, due to which Ali, this woman gave birth to the son of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, whose name was Muhammad ibn Hanafiya rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu. Now if Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu did not believe Abu Bakr to be the correct Khalifa, this would mean for him to go out in jihad without a Khalifa is wrong. Second, if going into that jihad is wrong, as in according to Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because Abu Bakr isn't the Khalifa, this is not even a jihad. How can you fight a jihad without a Khalifa? If that is not a jihad, then capturing this woman and taking her as a concubine is wrong, because you can't do this. You can't just walk out onto the street and any woman you fancy her and take her as a concubine and begin engaging in coitus with this woman. Absolutely wrong in Islam. So to go out and to capture this woman, that is also wrong. And thirdly, then to engage in coitus, to copulate with this woman, na'udhu billahi min zalik, is totally far, it is ba'id from the splendor of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu going and fighting this jihad, capturing this woman, then engaging in coitus, is all a blatant evidence that he radiallahu anhu believed Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu to be the truthful and the rightly guided Khalifa appointed by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And if we believe that Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, if we believe that Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu stayed a hypocrite during the Khalifa, the Khilafat of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, then what it would necessitate is that Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu fought a jihad without a Khalifa, he captured a woman who he wasn't supposed to be capturing, and he engaged in coitus with somebody who he wasn't in a wedlock with. The fourth thing is that this great Imam, according to the Shias, may Allah have mercy upon him, because we also even love him, that this great Imam, according to the Shias, was born from an illegitimate relationship with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from such beliefs.
Amen.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.